Hi everyone, thanks for joining us. Today we're going to talk a little bit about IEC 61000-4-2, specifically on the ESD table and how you can save yourselves a couple $100, either by making it or by having it made locally for you. Keep in mind we do also rent as well as sell the tables and the setups, so more information is available out there in the description. Without further ado, let's get started. Before we dive into looking at the table, there's a couple factors we want to discuss. You can see on the board right here is the standard requirements. So that's IEC 61000-4-2 that we use for our ESD table. Again, that specifies that 160 by 80 centimeter tabletop. The all wood required by the standard. So that means there's no metallic parts, no screws, no metal bolts. It's all done by plastic. And the final consideration is the design. Do you need to have the legs to be able to be removed? Does the table need to come apart? Is it stationary? These are all factors that you consider when you're designing it, as you're definitely going to have an impact on the type of materials you need. So let's go ahead and take a look at the bottom side of the table and you get an idea of how everything kind of fits together. All right, taking a look here, you'll see a couple of the different components. You see the tabletop, the top part of the frame. You'll see the inside frame right here, which is going to go on the inside of your legs. And then down here, you'll see one of the legs. So taking a look at the bottom part here, you'll see a couple of different L shapes here. And this goes into the design phase, is we wanted the legs to be able to come out. So what we did was we made a little L pattern allowing the legs to slide in. And again, this is all wood tables, so all the joints here, 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 and all around the table are all held together by pins and wood glue as opposed to screws or bolts. So taking a look, what you have here is you have actual holes drilled in through there, as a way to hold the legs in. Now, the leg would just slide in right like that, and then you would insert a bolt. So it's up for the time being. Let's take a look at the bolts. So what we did is we bought threaded rod. Finding large plastic bolts with nuts is actually pretty difficult. So what we did is we bought threaded rod. You can find information about where to buy it in the description below. And we cut them to length, and we have two different sizes. One being for the larger ones that are going to go through the top part right up here, going through 2 2x4s, and then the littler one, which is just going to go through 1 2x4 and the leg itself, keeping it from moving. So those are available. They're easy to come by. And again, once you order it, you just cut it to length. It's pretty straightforward. So let's take a look here. Let's take a look at the top part of the table and see how we secured the actual tabletop to the inside of the frame. All right, taking a look here, you'll see the top part of our table. You'll notice a couple holes here. These are for the pins, and so you can fill those in if you'd like. Again, for our example here, we didn't put the metal on yet. We wanted to give you guys a look and see how we secured our tabletop to our frame. Once the pins were in, we then clamped along the side of the table, ensuring a good solid hold from the frame to the top. When you're doing that, you also want to consider the weight of the test equipment, which you can be testing with, as well as the EUT. If you're going to have a considerable amount of weight, you may want to add additional pins or consider additional bracing. So why don't we go ahead, we'll get the table assembled, we'll give you guys a quick look at it. Taking a look here, you'll find our ESD table all assembled. You will notice one of the bolts right here. You can see it. Our table has 8 bolts to allow for shipping, and the legs come off. Again, if you guys don't need the capabilities, you can, of course, just make it all one solid piece. So we hope you guys learned a little bit about the required assembly for this ESD table per IEC 61000-4-2. We do also rent as well as sell them per the standard. And of course, when you rent it over by them, they will have the metal on the top of the table as well. So we look forward to hearing from you guys, and thanks for your time.